little bit about me. I'm half black, half Salvadorian, which means I just look like I'm Filipino. I know some of you guys are thinking, is he gonna start singing karaoke? I'm not Filipino. I'm not. Everywhere I go, I get that question. Even had an old Filipino man ask me twice, like I was gonna change my answer the second time. He goes, hey, you Filipino? Like, no, I'm not Filipino. You sure you're not Filipino? I think I know if I was Filipino, everybody. I don't think my mom was keeping that as a secret. That'd be a bit of a shock. Could you imagine if she called me tomorrow and let me know the news? That'd be amazing. Just, hey, what's up, mom? Hey, son, I need to talk to you. All right, mom, but why you got a Filipino accent? Okay, surprise! The Filipinos! I don't think that's gonna happen, you guys. I am what I am. I'm also 5'5 and a half, which means I'm the average female height. Yes, all right, I've accepted it already. I've accepted it. It's cool. I mean, being short is cool as a guy, I guess. It's not a problem. What I'm upset about is when I go to these public restrooms and they got the toilet that sits this high up. You ever seen that mess? That is the most ridiculous thing ever. I am convinced that there is a tall 6 foot plus plumber going around installing these damn things. I got him now. Let's see him climb up on this. That's not fair. It's a little unfair when I gotta jump up on the damn toilet just to get on top. Now my tippy toes are the only thing on the ground. First of all, everybody knows when you're trying to take a dump, you gotta push from the hill up. It's a little uncomfortable when I'm tippy toeing this poop out of me. It's not fair. And what's really not fair is when you go to these public restrooms and they don't have the lock that works. Now I gotta use the other foot to hold the door. Hey man, hold on. Somebody's in this bathroom. Hold on. They can't tell because my feet don't touch the ground. It's not fair. What I hate sometimes, you know, I lay out the little sheet, put the little sheet down. Sometimes I gotta do this little thing where I scoot on it and push myself all the way onto the toilet. Now the whole sheet done left. Now I got bare cheeks on the toilet. That is just not healthy. I know, ew, that's what I said one time. I was sitting there releasing my stuff and this guy walked in and he went to the bathroom and he just sat down immediately. I said, ugh. I wanted to let him know, like, just, hey man, you don't know who cheeks was on before yours. Man, that's unsanitary is all I'm saying. Have some bathroom etiquette, people, that's all I'm saying. That is my message for this bathroom joke. Have some bathroom etiquette. And tall dudes, please be nice. Stop being jerks when you're in the bathroom. Had this guy go to the bathroom one time. I was in the bathroom. And this guy came up and I was like, uh-oh, maybe I should let him know that somebody's in here. But before I got a chance to do that, he did one of these tall jerk moves like this. Oh, somebody's in this bathroom. I wonder what? A simple knock would have sufficed. My only option to do is just go, this bathroom is occupied, sir. I just felt a little uncomfortable, you guys. I didn't really want to look at another man's eye color while my booty hole was open. It's not fair for me. It's not fair is all I'm saying. It's too much pressure in life. Too much pressure. Oh, no, man. I'm only 30 years old, you guys. I know the hairline says 53. I don't know, can you see this right here? I got a little hair that popped up. You see that right there? Yeah. I saw that when I got out of the shower this morning, you guys. I said, ah, shit. Keeping hope alive right here. Keeping hope alive. I used to use Rogaine, but that crap didn't work. So I switched over to chia seeds. It's amazing. Just did what the directions said. Apply evenly, spread water, and watch the magic grow. I did that, and now two hairs popping right up. Said cha-cha-cha-chia, 2015, I think the wind caught it, 2015. I don't know, man. Have fun with life, you guys. I don't care what y'all look like, have fun with life. Life's too short. I don't care if you're short, tall, fat, or skinny. Enjoy your damn self, man. It's too much pressure for us to look a certain way. Yes, one person clapped it up. I guess the rest of them don't enjoy it. So. It's all right, man. But like I said, man, it's too much pressure for us as a society to look a certain way, you know? Everybody can't look like they look on those fitness magazines or the gym. Anybody been to the gym lately? Yeah? Oh, God, I hate that crap. The gym, ain't nothing in the gym but a bunch of buff-ass fools walking around trying to spot somebody. I hate that. If you've been to the gym, you know what I'm talking about. I hate that mess, man. This one guy gonna come behind me talking about, go ahead, E. I got you, player. Do your thing, man. Do your thing! Like, fool, I'm stretching. Now get your balls off my back. It's messed up. Fellas, make sure you wear the proper gym attire too, please. Men should not be in the gym wearing leggings. It's not fair for the rest of us in there, you know? It's just not fair. You want to jump on the treadmill, do 1,000 miles per hour, now you got your testicles swinging like a pendulum. I really don't need to be seeing that when you on the treadmill. I'm on the bench press machine trying to get my last rep. I'm a little dehydrated. I go to lick my lips and then we make eye contact. Now I'm at the gym making life decisions. It's just, I came here to work out. This didn't come with my membership. It just isn't fair sometimes. Too much, man. It's too much. It's too much. I don't know. This world's crazy. It's crazy. It's a crazy world, man. Now the presidential, the election is coming up, next year, I believe it is? I think it is, right? 2016, same thing with the Olympics. Yeah, that's crazy. How many people in here are actually going to vote this coming up election? See? 8 years ago, everybody's raising their hand. Yeah, I'm going to vote, yeah. I got a voice, I want them to hear me. You realize that now, this is the bullshit, huh? Voting, I'm not going to vote. I think they need to have something more useful on the ballot. That's all I'm thinking. Like prostitution. Fellas, you with me? Only the single guys, huh? The rest of the people with the couples. It's all right, fellas. If you want your wife or your girl, blink one for no and two for yes. See a couple of guys in here blinking out in like they lost their mind. Life is gonna point you out. It's all right. I don't know, man. I like prostitution, man. Some of y'all might frown upon that, but I like it, man. To me, prostitution is like going to Baskin Robbins. 31 different flavors. Take your pick. Just make sure you don't pick the female with the sprinkles. Yeah, I'm originally from San Francisco. You gotta be careful over there. I don't know, man. It is what it is, man. Technology is another thing too, you guys. Think we're doomed as a society. Technology is taking over. Like, you cannot hide from anybody nowadays on the internet. Anyone can find you. It's crazy. Like, I just recently found my biological father, you guys, on Facebook. I did. I sent him a friend request. He gonna send me back a message talking about, I didn't want you as a kid, why would I want you as a friend? I lost more hair when I saw that message. You know what, you're not even gonna get a Father's Day card. Father's Day. Real quick, I wanna say shout out to all the fathers in here that licked it before they staked it. And actually stuck with the kid and watching their seed grow. Kudos to you guys. Hey, you guys, my name is Eric Murphy. Thank you guys for listening to me. Look me up on Facebook or Twitter. Enjoy the rest of the show.